We just received some brand new information about Firefight coming into Halo Infinite. We recently saw the trailer that went live, just kind of reiterated everything we already talked about here on the channel, but now we have a full-on blog that gives you all the nice little details of everything you need to know about the survival mechanics, about the maps that are in the game, and all the different design choices that they made, especially with the skulls. What makes this Firefight mode very different than what we've had previously is obviously the King of the Hill mechanic, so how's that gonna work out within Halo Infinite? But they say here saying that in matchmaking modes will have exactly 5 hills for each match, and you'll get a win if you capture at least 3 of them throughout the round. If you guys like these informative videos, make sure you tap like for algorithm reasons, and if you're part of the 81% of people who are not subscribed, well, you know what to do then to keep up to date with everything going on with Halo. The way you score a point is by capturing it and then defeating the boss wave that comes in. Once a hill gets to a certain percentage captured, then a boss wave comes in, so you have to not only capture the hill but also clear out the boss wave, then you earn the point for the victory for the next set of hills. Basically, the way this whole thing is going to work out, saying that when the game starts, a hill will spawn and waves of a progressively harder banished enemies will try to capture that hill. Your job is to take the hill from them and hold it until you capture it. A boss wave filled with tougher than usual enemies and spearheaded by a named high value target or boss spawns once you've reached a certain amount of hill progress. Interesting thing is that it says that the timer in the mode is technically unlimited, but games tend to run about 15 to 20 minutes. Unlike in traditional Firefight where you have a life pool and once you run out of lives, then the game ends. There are no extra lives within King of the Hill Firefight. So the way it works is that they have a revive mechanic, much like you have in attrition, same kind of idea, but applied to Firefight. So once all players are downed, that's when the round ends. But don't worry, for all you classic fans, there are options within the custom game to have a more traditional experience with Firefight. If your team makes it through a hill set, you actually earn skulls add on to that difficulty, but then you do earn more points, which would make towards progression, which we'll talk about later in this video. But they stay right here saying that the rules for skulls in Firefight King of the Hill work like this. If a team wins a point and nobody dies, one semi-random skull gets enabled for the next hill. Skulls stack over the course of the game. You can have multiple skulls active if you keep winning points without any fire team members' deaths. In matchmaking, the maximum active skulls you can have is 4 skulls on the 5th hill. Streaks can be dropped. Losing a hill to the banished will disable your most recently added skull. 343 says semi-random skulls get enabled because they like to mix it up a little bit, so the lesser difficult skulls get added on early, and then as you progress through the game, if you get a nice little win streak when it comes to hill captures, then the harder skulls get added in later on. So they are still randomized, but at a fixed point in a way. Let me show you what I'm talking about. For example, the first skull you earn will always be either fog or catch. But if you earn a second skull, the pool expands to include famine and thunderstorm. The list of skulls you can have within Firefight is fog, which disables the motion tracker, catch, AI enemies throw and drop more grenades, famine, weapon drops by AI enemies have half the amount of ammo they normally do, thunderstorm upgrades the rank of most AI enemies, mythic AI enemies have significantly increased health, and black eye, your shields only recharge with a melee. Additionally, there is a very small chance you'll get one of the following skulls enabled at the start of a round. These skulls don't increase the difficulty, but they add some more fun moments. Like they mentioned boom, which doubles the explosion radius, which I would think actually makes things more difficult rather than fun, but still fun in the same process. But then cowbell, acceleration from explosions is increased. That's always amazing. And of course, the most important skull of all time, grunt birthday skull. The grunt headshots lead to a glorious celebration. Bandana grants unlimited ammo and grenades and removes equipment cooldown. And the I would have been your daddy skull. Rare combat dialogue becomes more common and vice versa. 343 does say that the blind skull, which hides first person HUD elements and view models, is not in the pool for the mode, but is available for custom games and node graphing. So in summary, for the TLDR of what King of the Hill Firefight brings for us, saying players get points by capturing a hill and killing the boss wave for the hill, not just surviving. If the Spartans fail to hold the hill, the Banish will capture it instead. No more shared life pools. You have one life, but your teammates can be revived like attrition. All spawns downed at the same time will end the round instantly. You can use custom game options to get a more classic life pool setting, and the players earn skulls by winning hills without dying and skulls stack. But what about XP, career rank, battle pass progression? How would that work with this? Saying in matchmaking, you'll get a small amount of match XP just for playing. Additionally, you'll get bonus XP for a win, which is capturing 3 of the 5 hills. Successfully capturing the 4th and 5th hill will each give an additional XP bonus. Slaying banished foes will award personal score throughout the entire round that will level up your career rank, and the skulls will also net players a stacking personal score bonus at the end of each round, 1 for every skull that is enabled. Again, once we know exactly how the XP rates work within Firefight, I'll definitely make a video talking about if it's a great mode when it comes to XP ranking up. We do plan to do a live stream of this mode as well on the launch of it as well, so make sure you subscribe to the channel and make sure you follow the Koth live stream. But you know, now you're probably wondering, you've heard 9 maps, 3 community made maps, and the House of Reckoning. So what's going to be the play? What can we use the play with this Firefight mode? Well, it's in the 9 maps include the House of Reckoning, which is the new map right from campaign, Behemoth, Deadlock, Launch Site, which I'm not the biggest fan of, but I've heard it works well with Firefight, Live Fire, which can be an interesting close quarters kind of map, Oasis, which we saw in the trailer, Exiled, Nisi Bay, which is going to be the Zanzibar remake from the Squad Battles playlist, as well as Valheim, which is the Squad Battles remake of Valhalla. So those are the 3 community made maps. I was kind of hoping for some unique maps, but hey, you know what? I'm sure that they, since already in matchmaking, they had to already have the AI pathing already made for those maps, meaning that to get the mode out just to get people to play it, they probably had to play on somewhat vanilla maps or maps already within the rotation. 343 also showed here the custom game options, and basically you can just customize it however you like, just like as you could previously, but probably even more, which is going to be a great thing for all you forgers out there, especially since 343 did state that they want to add in community made maps into the Firefight playlist as soon as possible. We do know that the turnaround when it comes to arena maps from Forge to be put into matchmaking is about 8 to 10 weeks. Now, when it comes to Firefight maps being added into matchmaking, it really depends, I'm sure, of the complexity of the map, the complexity of the rounds, what type of experience that they want to have with those modes, but maybe it'd be less time or maybe about the same because it's only PvE, right? You don't have to worry about it being like functionally competitive and balanced and things like that. You just need to make sure it's fun. Not only is it amazing gameplay coming in with Halo Infinite's Firefight, but there's a new networking model which will fix desync. They mentioned this in the previous blog, which I covered on the channel here previously, but so we're all on the same page, saying December 5th with the December update, you'll be able to jump into Firefight King of the Hill playlist and try out the new networking model in a safe environment. They did state that if the results are promising, we'll look to host a PvP experience in the combat workshop in the future. So basically keep an eye out if desync happens with you guys. I haven't really experienced it a whole lot. It does happen, especially when it comes to the Forge maps. And I do know that Forges basically have to nerf their maps because of desync, or it really extends out the time when it comes to turnaround on that. So if 343 finds ways to fix desync even faster and make it even better, it would be great. Desync, the days are numbered. Now, we recently got some information about the Halo TV show coming out on February 8th. I have a video talking about 5 facts you don't know about the Halo TV show season 2. Check out that video if you guys want to see some more Halo content from me. And thank you all for watching. Peace out.